السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today's lesson is about the ميم ساكنة in Quran. ميم ساكنة, you will find it either in this way, ميم without any sign on it, or in this way, you will find the سكون sign on it. This is the سكون in Quran. So the ميم ساكنة has only three simple rules. One of them is إدغام. Let's see the إدغام. The idgham, we say idgham shafawi. You will see the mim without any sign and followed by a mim with shadda. This is the shadda. You have to do ghunna in this case. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَهُمْ مُوسَى mim and mim. You have to do ghunna. You will find the other mim with shadda, the first mim. You will not find any sign on it. So you will read وَلَقَدْ جَاءَهُمْ مُوسَى. You have to do the غُنَّة or the nasal sound two counts. Then we have إخفاء الشفوي. إخفاء الشفوي, the letter for إخفاء الشفوي is ba. You will find ميم ساكنة without any sign followed by ba with فتحة, with كسرة, with ضمة, doesn't matter. It should be only ba. وهم بالآخرة. Here also you will do the nasal sound, which we call it al-ghunna. وهم بالآخرة. So this is إخفاء. The letter for إخفاء is ba. The last simple rule is إظهار شفوي. إظهار شفوي is when you see the ميم ساكنة with the sign and followed by any alphabet letter, except of course for the ba and for the ميم. Then you will find ميم ساكنة with سكون with the sign on it followed by any other alphabet, Arabic alphabet. So you will read the ميم clearly. إظهار means clear. So you will read the ميم without any nasal sound, without any غنة. لهم نار, لهم نار جهنم. Here you is followed by فا. عليهم فيموتوا, عليهم فيموتوا. So without any sign, without any غنة. So for ميم, for إظهار, you will find the sign on it. For ba, you will not find any sign. And for إظهار, you will not find any sign. So this is the simple rule of ميم ساكنة.